A man in Washington, D.C. sheltered dozens of protesters from arrest this week by welcoming them into his home. Rahul Dubey helped more than 70 people Monday as police used pepper spray to crack down on a 7 p.m. curfew. He ultimately let them stay overnight until the curfew was lifted and even provided food. Now those he helped are hailing him as a hero. And Rahul Dubey joins me now. Hi, Rahul. Thank you for being with us. You're being credited with helping so many people. Why did you decide to let so many strangers, really, into your home?
Hi, it's a pleasure to be here, and I really appreciate the opportunity to be able to tell this story of the atrocities and terror and pretty much the worst experience of my entire life and those of the 70-plus people that were here with me in solidarity after seeing the horrific use of force that was not even instigated by a group of peaceful protesters on Swan Street, Northwest DC, on Monday night. It was one of those things where it was very instinctual. It was unfathomable. I'm still processing it, but I have 70 plus people, a neighborhood, a city, countries, and people all over the world that are throwing support to all of us through social media, through leaving flowers and cookies and food on the steps in which the atrocities took place. So it's been a pretty interesting run since Monday.
And tell us about the atmosphere inside your home when all of these protesters were there. How long did they stay? Was it a somber atmosphere? I mean, what you're describing sounds pretty chilling. Or was there, you know, sort of a sense in being this together that kept it a little upbeat?
The best way that I can describe it is in almost three phases. There was a time between 8:45 p.m. on Swan Street to about 9:20 when the mayhem broke loose and the police unleashed hell on innocent protesters about 30 yards away from my stoop. And when I saw that happening, I heard a big bang. I heard pounding of batons, cracking of shields, screaming, screeches that were... I still remember faces gnarled, teeth by the police that were spraying people in the back of the heads, hitting people as they were running away. It was one of those just 10 minutes of people streaming into my house, the first floor. That filled up. I was yelling, but holding the door open, trying to tell people there was an upstairs, downstairs, and backyard. And what ended up happening is the police pushed all the people past my stoop. And at that moment, there was nothing left in that wake. And I was able to shut the door, get everybody in that I needed to, and be able to get attention to within the 70 plus people that were in the house that were pepper sprayed, that were hit, coughing, couldn't breathe, crying. It was a total nightmare of an hour and a half inside the house. And we were able to overcome that once the pepper spray dissipated. They sprayed pepper spray into the house. We were able to overcome that, take a moment, and around 11 p.m., 11:15 p.m., we started looking at how we were going to get out, what was going to happen. And at 12:30, we made the decision that it was going to be virtually impossible to trust the police who were trying to get in the house illegally, who were trying to trick us, who hijacked our pizza. So I said to them, everyone is welcome to stay here until 6 o'clock. We're going to figure out how to get you home and get you some cars. It wasn't even my idea. They were all self-managing. They were all strangers. They were all being human. And the goal at that moment at 12:30 a.m. was right after around 6, we are going to get everyone home and they will sleep in their beds tonight. And that was the goal. And we hunkered down until 6 a.m., executed beautifully. And during that period of time, across 8.5 hours before curfew was lifted, we had one-on-one conversations. I saw groups of 3 and 4 talking about the atrocities that were taking place on throughout the week, different areas, how it was happening. And it was more of the solidarity. And it was not trying to locate a personal affinity, but to develop one. And that was the biggest challenge that I think, is that lack of communication and understanding that what makes us different is what makes us great as a collective. And we saw that on display here at my home with 70 plus amazing souls, amazing neighbors that were dropping off supplies, phone calls from lawyers offering help, giving me little pieces of advice that went so long. I thank you. And it really renewed our faith in humanity and has energized us where, you know, we have to be at this level, because you had a global pandemic with an economic, global economic meltdown and revealed systemic racism happening all at once. And we need to be the best versions of ourselves, and we have not been.
All right. Well, Rahul Dubey, thank you so much for sharing your extraordinary story with us.
Thank you very much for allowing me to share it, and be safe. Please vote. Thank you.